Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Suikoden 5 in the last episode. What did we do? we made it here to Raffleet. That's right. Met the old lady, brought back her little, brought back two of her minions, and, they're busy cutting up some nasty-ass fish or something. Anyways, before we leave Raffleet, I'm thinking something's going to happen, because she told us to go look around. So I'm kind of just going to take one quick stroll around the city, which we already did last episode, but I'm going to make sure that we don't miss anything. I was kind of hoping that we'd come across little Miss Beaver, or Mr. Beaver. I don't even know if it was a male or female beaver. But we could always use more beaver in our lives, if you know what I'm saying. So let's go find ourselves a little more beaver. I don't know if that's actually what we're going to end up running into before we leave. I really don't know what other thing is going to happen before we leave here. But I fully expect something to go down before we leave. Indeed. Last episode was pretty eventful. I mean, we did the whole purification rite thingy, and we caught the thieves, the gold thieves, and we brought them back here, and then we met the old lady. I mean, we did quite a bit of shit. Let's go this way first. This way is like the other half of the town, so we'll start with the other half of the town. See if we can find anything new going on over here that I didn't already take care of or see. There's a rune shop there, there's a there, blacksmith and all that good stuff. What about over here? Okay. I think I have to go through the blacksmith to see the rest of it then. Through the blacksmith. Then you gotta go this way and see if there's anybody over here. Yeah, I fully expect this to be pretty quick. Because we're just gonna look for cutscenes and or people to talk to that we didn't see before. That's all we're looking for right now. So far, all I see is the same townsfolk we already talked to. I see no point in talking to them again. To them again. I don't know. Maybe we won't run into anything interesting until we actually try to leave. We shall see, though. I don't want to miss out on any little triggers that we need to have to trigger any recruits for later on in the game. I mean, I'm probably going to keep saying that. And eventually, we'll probably find stuff that's relevant and necessary. I mean, we found some in the episode before where we were leaving the city. The big city, Felina, Sol Felina. We found some cutscenes that may or may not be important for recruiting people later. So I want to make sure we keep on that track and make sure we at least look around semi-thoroughly in towns. Give them a second over when something changes, you know? It's always good to do. For future reference, I will probably be doing this sort of thing off-screen, where I walk around a town a second time until I show something interesting or something that's different. But right now, since we're still on our first time through the town, pretty much, I figure I'll just show the re-exploration. I'm kind of hoping one of these houses that was empty before might have somebody in it now. Don't start hiccup burping now. That's disgusting. I'm starting to think there's not going to be anything here. Unless the inn's going to have something. I don't think we are going to find anything interesting. Well, that's sad. Sad story. Wow. It took longer to load the inside. It didn't. I shouldn't be surprised. It took longer to load the outside than it did the inside. The outside's a bigger area, duh. I guess we're done here, then. There's not a goddamn soul walking around this new. I guess we're just gonna get the fuck out of here. Bye, Raffleet. Bye, Felicia. There was just nothing else left there to do. I mean, I walked around, there's nothing. I guess we're just gonna head back, then. Fuck it. Should we stop by the Eastern Palace on the way? Sure, why not? Let's just give it a quick once-over. Like I said, you should always kind of look over places when things change. And this time we don't have the princess with us, so maybe we should just take a quick look around. I'm wondering if and when we're going to run into the boob lady that we ran into here last time, who warned us that we failed as the royalty and have not retrieved the Dawn Rune. Also, I wonder who took the Dawn Rune. We haven't met anybody who seems like the culprit. Not to me, anyways. I mean, for all I know, it was one of the godwins of the barrows, and yeah, that's it. But I feel like there's villains we haven't met yet, besides the godwins of the barrows. I feel like there's other villains. I mean, like I said, we met that chick who was talking about the Donruan, but I feel like she's more like a Lechnat character, which I'm also not sure if Lechnat's in this game, FYI. I don't think we really need to be here. I'm leaving. So, yeah, I guess we'll just kind of keep floating along in the story until we actually get to the point of when the game becomes true Suikoden status, where we start doing all the recruiting and stuff. I look very much forward to that point in the game when we get there. But first, we have to have a trigger as to why we would even need to do such a thing. Because right now, we're not even a leader, really. We're just the prince. We're not the like, our mom is the queen, and the dad is the king slash whatever. And then my sister is the one in line for the throne. So what the fuck's the point of me? I mean, the only reason for me to be important is if my entire family died. But hey, don't fucking foreshadow something that sad. I don't know if I can handle something that sad. Would it really go so far as to kill everyone in my family and make me have to, like, avenge them? That would be crazy. I almost kind of want that to happen now. I don't think that will. I think more likely what's going to happen is, if you want me to actually guess, because I think we might be closing in on it actually happening. Like, by it, I mean, we might be getting close to the point where big story shit's going to go down. Here's my guess. I'm just going to go ahead and flat out say, we're already 12 episodes in this Let's Play. I need to start speculating on what I think's going to happen. And I swear to God, if any of you confirm or deny what I say, I'm going to be mad. So just don't say anything, an opinion to what I'm guessing right now. Just listen to it and say, that's cool. We'll have to just see if that happens. I think mom's dead. Mom's going to get killed. I don't know who's going to be behind it. I think the Godwins are the obvious guess, but I think somebody else may obviously be the one that actually ends up pulling the trigger, so to speak. I think dad's going to go down with her. He's too nice. He might be cool or badass, but if mom goes down, he might have to go down just to get to her. Or other way around, dad goes down and mom gets super pissed and gets possessed by the rune, and then she goes super apeshit in evil mode, which also could happen. Those are two options when it comes to people dying. Dad seems like he's totes dead. The fact that dad is so nice, Farid, we're talking about Farid here, the fact that he's so freaking nice is bad omen in a game like this. He's so fucked. There's enough nice people already in this game that aren't important. Because he's nice and he's important, super dead. Super dead. For all I know, I'm being too morbid and none of this is going to happen, but I'm just going with what I think. If he dies, mom goes crazy, or if they both die, then princess is in line for the throne, and then Godwin kidnaps her, takes her over, holds her hostage, whatever, and then leaves me to be, like, the one to rescue her. That's kind of how I'm looking at what the story is going towards here. And then if it's the other way around, where if dad dies and then mom freaks out and goes possession mode, then mom becomes the evil person in the game and we gotta stop her. That would be even more, that would actually be more of a sad scenario in my opinion. I mean, mom and dad both dying, I could see that as being a vengeance story. But just dad dying and then mom going nuts over the being possessed evilly by the rune, that's one I could totes see. By the way, speaking of dad, well, Funky G, Silead, you're back. Welcome home, dudes! Thanks, Kyle.
What? Only Farid and Kyle? That's hardly a welcome.
Ouch, that hurts, bruh.
Sorry about that. I thought it'd be better if we kept the little nature of our visit to Raffleet quiet.
True dad. Yakis filled me in on what happened. Thank you for taking care of that.
You're damn right, it's what we do.
Take care of business.
George, Leon, thank you. Sorry for all the extra trouble.
Nah, it was hardly what I could call a trouble.
And we got to meet lots of new people, and it was fun too.
Ha ha ha, that's good then. I'd like to hear what you have to say too, but you must be tired. Why don't you go ahead and get some rest now? Oh, but before you do, you better say hello to your mother. I think she's in her chamber now.
Alright, let's go say hi to Mommy. Hey, Mom.
Well, I guess I'll take a bath and freshen up then. No peeking!
Oh, I'll join you, bruh!
Are you serious?
Kyle, seriously.
Sorry, just kidding.
You'd better be.
Have I mentioned how glad I am that I didn't let you go to Lunas? Farid knew, man.
Only several times today, Your Majesty!
I'll just go make myself comfortable in the guard room for now.
Oh, George, by the way, come visit me later. Sometime this evening would be fine. Okay.
Got it.
Alright, so George off to rest, Siley's off to bathe, and of course Leon will follow me around as usual as we go talk to my mommy. Mommy, I'm home! Where are you? She's in her chambers, huh? Let's talk to this guy first. What's up, Doc? Oh, this is Kyle.
What's up, Prince? How was it, bruh? Oh, come on, you know what I'm talking about, bruh? Purification right, man. You must have taken a peek, huh? Am I right? I'm right, right? Hey, who looked the hottest? Well, no need to ask, really. It had to be Siley's, bro. You're kidding me. You didn't look? Why the hell not? That was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, bruh.
I know. But guess what? Those are my fucking family members, sick freak. All right. Yeah. Your mother's in the back room. Don't keep her waiting. All right. I'll go to her back room. Not the audience chamber, right? Is there a room behind the audience chamber? Let's see if that's true. Inner chamber? Is this where she is? Prince, I'll wait here. Okay, so this is where she is. I've never even been back here before. How come?
Her Majesty hardly ever invites you to her chamber. I bet she has something she wants to talk to you about in private.
Damn right. You stay there, Leon. Let's see if Mom goes ape. By that, I mean, like, you know, it does a little freak-out mode where she goes evil. Let's see.
Oh, welcome home. Isn't Leon with you? I see. She wanted to give us some time alone, did she? Come on. Come a little closer. So you made friends with not only Haswar, but Raja, too, did you? What did you think? They're nice people, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Getting the support of those two will prove to be very helpful to you someday, I'm sure. And that day might not be very far away.
Also, this is a throwback song, by the way.
Gazelle is coming the day after tomorrow. I want you to know we're not just waiting around without any plan. We're taking every measure we can. We're certainly not going to let Godwin have everything his way. I wanted to tell you at least that much. Now go back to your room and get some rest, okay?
Thanks, Mom, for reassuring me of something I already knew from your cutscene.
But at least now I know in person. Wait. Aw, Mommy gave me a hug. When can I get out of these stupid clothes, by the way?
A great big man like your father, Ferry. I've really been blessed with wonderful children. Both you and Lynn. I want you both to know how truly proud I am to have you.
See, too much goodwill happening right now. Shit's gonna go down and everything's gonna be bad.
Oh, Prince, you're done with your talk?
Huh?
Your face is all red.
Don't worry about it.
Well, I guess it's none of my business then.
Damn right it's not. Okay then. I wonder when all the shit's gonna... It's gotta go down soon. If Godwin's on his way here, only bad things can come of that, right? I don't know. Let's just ride it out and see what happens, man. I'm getting a little antsy to finally find out what fuck happens. Alright, time to go to bed then, huh? Hey, Dad, what's up?
You'll need to do a few things to prepare yourself for the engagement ceremony, too. But we can discuss that later. After you go see Lim, you should get some rest.
Oh, now I have to go see Lim now, too?
I thought I was about to go to sleep right now, but no, I gotta go talk to Lim first.
Alright, fine. It's okay, she's probably waiting for me anyways. That girl is all over the goddamn place, always be following me around and shit, waiting around for me and shit. Aw, shit. Alright, sis, where you at? Siley's room? Whoops.
Oh, Prince Fucky G, Lady Siley's is in the bath at the moment.
Okay, thanks for telling me that detail, bodyguard. Lim Slaya, there's where I needed. Lim, you here? She is.
The princess seems to be in denial about the engagement. She's just refusing to accept it. I don't blame her, though. Godwin's kind of a dish.
Mucky D, you're back! How was Raffly? I wish I could have gone with you.
Okay. Is that it?
I can't believe I'm actually getting engaged. None of this seems real to me.
Uh-huh. Anything else? Okay. That's it. That's all you had to say. It's fine. What about you, Miakis? What do you think about all this?
Welcome back, Prince.
That's it? All you have to say is welcome?
Welcome back, Prince.
Well, you too. Nice to see you too.
I don't know. Will Master Chisel look after the princess properly? I hope he will.
Nope. He's gonna prison that bitch. He gonna wait till she's a fucking grown-ass lady, F her till she has a daughter, kill all the sons, and then... No, I'm just kidding. I have no idea. I don't know how ruthless these people really are. Godwin and fucking Barrows, they seem like fucking douchebag politicians who have zero fucking skills with fighting at all. All they know how to do is spread the word secretly and be all behind the scenes and shit like a bunch of fucking backwards ass politicians. It's kind of garbage, but you know what? That's what the fucking rich do, man. They just get people to fight their battles for them, and that's how this feels so far. And it's fine. I'm not complaining. I'm just pointing out the way the fucking people are, man.
Welcome back, Your Highness. Are you ready for bed?
I suppose I am. There's not much else I can do at the moment unless I go wandering around looking for a cutscene, so let's just sleep.
All right, Your Highness. Good night.
Good night. And goodbye.
Seriously, though. If I have to go through this whole game in these fucking clothes, I'm not going to be a happy person. I don't think I have to, though. I'm pretty sure in the opening, like, video, they show the main character in a different outfit. I hope that's soon. Anyway.
Man. Is that why you invited me to Felina? To ask me to do that? Uh-oh.
Something very important.
I can't say that I wasn't part of the reason. If that time ever comes, I'll do it myself if I have to, no matter how hard it would be.
Oh, shit.
But if, for whatever reason, I can't, someone will have to do it. We must be prepared for anything. So you want me to be your backup plan, is that it?
Yes, you're the only one I can trust completely.
I hate this. I hate it.
I do too. Huh. Plan for what? If shit goes down, we murder the whole family and then, you know, murder-suicide the whole family? No? That's probably not it. I'm gonna go with that's probably not it. Today it's all about murder, guys. Today I'm all about morbid, murdery details. Also, boat on the way. I'm guessing that's Godwin.
Here he comes to wreck the day, Mr. Chisel himself.
Oh, doesn't he look extra douchey today? Oh, boy. Okay, well, we'll see how his shit goes. I still think, regardless of what goes down, it's not going to be all his plan. I think there's going to be a bigger scheme at work. I just don't know who's going to be behind it all yet. Anyway, here he is. And the Queen's Guard's like, God damn it. Are we really going to have to serve under this guy someday? Man. Rather die in battle before that point comes.
Hello.
Okay. No talking, just epic. Oh, and we got a banquet. Doesn't this look fancy? Fancy as fuck. Can I get out of my stupid outfit for the banquet? Or do I still gotta wear my stupid orange outfit? I mean, I don't care that it's orange. It looks like I'm probably gonna be wearing the same shit. Do we get to at least mingle a little bit? A little mingle? Nope. Maybe? I don't know. Wow, there's a whole lot of just cutting and not talking going on right now, isn't there? It's okay, this shows the passage of time, regardless if there's any talking going on. Anyway. Guys, what's with those faces? Who's that? Oh, that's who I kind of figured it was. Hey, Silids, how you doing, girl?
Lady Silids? This is supposed to be a happy occasion, but you two look so gloomy.
Don't worry about it.
To hell with this farce!
No. I mean, I guess we do.
Well, as long as you're aware of it. Now, quit being all wallflowers. I'll hang out with you, so come on.
Okay. So we're gonna go mingle. Let's go mingle then. Hey, dude, what's up, dog? Ah, if it isn't His Royal Highness, the Prince, then I'm related to the House of Godwin, Your Highness. No one cares, dude.
We shall, therefore, become kinsmen upon their marriage, so I do so look forward to seeing much more of Your Highness.
No, you don't. You don't give a shit. You're a noble. You just say stuff to sound good.
Oh, the princess must be ever so delighted that she's the very man with the pedigree of Sir Young Sir Jizzle. Probably not that excited, but you know what? Who's to say for sure?
Sir Jizzle has brought on quite a number of kinsmen, despite the regrettable absence of his father.
Yeah, his father didn't want to witness the garbage he's about to try and pull.
Oh, if it isn't this his Royal Highness the Prince, I am related to the House of Godwin, Your Highness. I already talked to you, and I didn't mean to talk to you again, sir.
My bad. My bad.
Sup, dude? What are you doing over here?
Some Feline queens are of old were wed even younger than Princess Lipsaya. Actually, it may have been best to hold the wedding today as well.
No. Nope.
Today merely marks their betrothal. I very much look forward to the day they actually wed.
That's a long time away, I'm sure.
This is truly an auspicious bond that has been tied. From this day forth, peace shall surely reign over Feline.
No, it won't. No, it won't. Finally, he says. Who is he, anyways? I didn't mean to leave, by the way. I didn't think I was going to actually be able to leave the room. I will leave the room and look around, but I wanted to make sure we mingle the whole room before we leave the room. Anybody else? More guards? Boy, this banquet is so it's not my place to say. Well, you're just a fucking guard. You don't get to enjoy it.
Chisel doesn't even have one female tenant. What's up with that, man? Does he even like girls? I guess his engagement isn't really the place for him to be bringing girls. But still, man, I'd be fucking girls by the fucking thousands if I had money like that shit, man.
Truth be told, I sold my land and hastily moved here to Solfalina so that I would be invited. Okay. What a dumbass. I feel a bit out of place here, Your Highness. Well, you're just a guard, so stand there and fucking do your job. Don't worry about how you feel.
The time has come for has not yet come, Your Royal Highness. It's too early to feel tense. Please preserve your patience.
Sir, yes, sir. All right, anybody else we haven't talked to? You.
Yes, what is it? Pardon me, I was lost in thought.
Okay, good for you.
In Feline, this is a tradition to hold a betrothal celebration between the two families in lieu of a large wedding. However, we nobles who reside here in Feline have been allowed to attend this fine celebration as well.
Good for you.
Oh, good for you!
Anyway.
Oh, the princess must be ever so delighted that she is to be wed to a man with a pedigree of Young Sir Jizzle. I already talked to you, didn't I?
Oh, my, what a splendid, fantastical occasion!
Okay. Semiakis. Hey, Prince. During the ceremony, you gotta shout.
No! You will pry my sister from my cold, dead hands! Come on, I dare ya!
That's what I'm gonna wanna say, just because I don't wanna fucking... I hate Jizzle. Here's Jizzle himself, by the way.
Greetings, Johan.
What did I do? Well, I forgot what I did with this guy's voice. Anyway, I made him sound all, like, proper, and then when he fucking started being all, like, not proper, I made him not proper. Anyway,
greetings, Your Highness. It's been far too long. First, allow me to apologize for the absence of my father. He would have liked to attend, but I requested that he stay home. Frankly, I would find it a little embarrassing were I to be accompanied by my father at this age.
Good for you. What's up, Dad? How's it going, Funky G? Have you had enough? Am I supposed to say yes? No, not yet.
I see. Well, this is a good opportunity to meet a lot of important people. Walk around and talk to everybody as much as you want.
I'm going to make sure we go around and do everything we possibly can during this, because this seems like a very specific sequence that is very rare. Anyway.
Why the long face, Funky G? You're here to celebrate your sister's engagement, trying to look happier. Even if it's only for a few hours.
Alright, thanks, Mom. What about you? What do you think, Lim?
Funky G, this is supposed to be a happy day, but I'm just so sad. And even I can tell everyone else has a fake smile on.
Yeah. Keep those smarts about you, man. Because without those, you're only going to fail. So make sure you just stay smart, girl. Just make sure you stay smart. Just stay smart. That's all I can say. I'm checking the inner chamber. I don't know. I feel like somebody might have snuck in here while we weren't looking. I'll appreciate people be sneaking around up in this bitch. Maybe I'm the one sneaking. I don't know. I never actually been in here other than in the cutscene a minute ago, so... Figured I'd take a quick look to see what's going on in there. Nothing, as I expected. But you never know who might be behind the scenes plotting, scheming.
Scheme, plot! I'm coming for that number one spot! Rappers swearing they all...
I fucking forgot the
words off, like the exact wording. Anyway, we're going to go this way into the kitchen area and see if there's anything going on over here right quick. Well, we're going to the left wing. Let's check the kitchen. I'm not a fan of the Godwins, to tell you the truth, Your Highness, but if we have to work with them, we will. We'll show them what a proud honor it is to be members of the Sun Palace staff. All right, well, that's nice. Wow, the Godwin chefs were absolutely magnificent. Such skill. But I don't know. Something up with the guys. Those guys, the chefs got their nose for these things, you know. Once the Godwin chefs finished preparing the mega food, they just left without so much as a goodbye. Frankly, their uncouth behavior sullies the name of chefs everywhere. What a bunch of a-holes. Bunch of unworthy chefs, those bastards. Those unworthy chef bastards. Shall I tell you about the arms invasion again, Your Highness? The one that happened 8 years ago. No, you shouldn't. I already learned. You taught me about it already. I'm actually surprised you can come talk to this guy right during this sequence. You know what? Can we go talk to Zegai right now? That'd be hilarious, actually. Or maybe there's already somebody down here doing that, just exactly that. Oh, maybe I can't. I might not be able to do this right now. Princess's engagement. Too bad this stupid thing's a big joke. But it's not. It's not a big joke. She's gonna get married to this guy unless we do something about it. This is happening. Like, it's only a big joke if something happens to stop it. Then it becomes a big joke. At this point in time, not really a big joke. I think she might be just referring to the fact that Godwin didn't really win fair and square. At least not his. Well, he didn't win shit. He just fucking let his fighter do the fucking fighting for him. But his fighter only won because fucking. He was behind the whole poisoning of freaking Belcoot. And that was not cool either. Can we go in Siley's room? I think her room's not that interesting, I suppose. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I'm just walking around because I can. I don't think there's any purpose to any of this right now. I'm just looking for something new to be going on in any of the rooms. I don't even know why I'm able to explore all this shit. What's the point? Your Highness shouldn't be back at the banquet? No, I shouldn't. I should be doing whatever I want, because I'm Your Highness, remember? I do what I want. And what I want is for you to stop fucking questioning all of the things that I try to do with my life. You do that again, I'll stab you in the face with a motherfucking soldering iron to the face. I'm gonna go out the front in a second. Can I go out this way? Might as well check both sides. I can't go up the stairs. So we might as well check both first floors and make sure there's nothing sneaky going on over here either. I'm gonna go with probably not, but you know, better safe than sorry, they always say, by checking all the rooms. You never know what room might have somebody hanging out in it that says some talking some shit or something and be like, yo, I'm the prince around here, don't be talking shit. Anybody in the Knight's Guard room? Nope. They are all doing their duty by being gods at the party where the whole royal family is in attendance. I really admire the courage of the Queen's Knights. I'm one of those people who gets so nervous when there's a big build-up. I couldn't cut it with them. Well then, you should probably just stay as a fucking door guard like you already are then. Stupid mofo. Your Highness, are you feeling nervous? Are you? You tell me, dude. I have no idea why I'm doing all this. I'm probably reaching for just something at this point. I'm not going in all these rooms. Which room is this last one, by the way? Oh, yeah, that room. Alright, let's just, I guess we'll just go to the front of the palace then, because there doesn't seem to be anything going on either side. Why do they even bother letting you go to either side? What's the point? I just don't see the point. They should just have it all blocked if there's nothing interesting. I don't know, man. Maybe this is the last time we'll ever get to walk around the palace. I don't know. I'm just guessing. I really don't know at all what the fuck's going on here. Whatever. We're going this way. Let's see if anything happens out here in the main lobby. Anything cool? The front of the Sun Palace? Anything cool out here, man? There's something wrong, Prince Funky G. Did you find the banquet boring? Frankly, it was rather boring. Oh, I can't go outside. Something wrong? You just can't go outside. All right, fair enough. I guess we're just going to go and say we're done because there's literally nobody to talk to that's got a face. Everybody here is knights, queen's knights, and douchebags. So that's all I got to say about that. Let's get the fudge. It's still early, but this day is about Lim.
She must be getting tired by now, too. We should call it a night.
Indeed. Because this party is a snore fest.
Gazelle, evening, sir.
Gizzle.
Banquet over already, sir?
Yes. It's the princess's bedtime, you see.
She's still a child, remember?
A little while ago, an attendant came by and brought us some of the banquet food. It was quite delicious.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hey, oh, shit. Oh, shit. Uh-oh.
Gazelle, sir. Please wait aboard the ship, sir. We'll come see you when it's
over. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Very well. The scholars have arrived. I want you to take them to the sealed room right away. Yes.
Is that?
No. That man in red. Something about his manner disturbs me. I want him watched. I'll put someone on him. You can rest assured. Fine. Do that.
You know what makes sense all of a sudden? Why they had the Godwin chefs cook all the food.
Worried about the lady, are we? How sentimental of you. You have your orders. Just do as instructed. Yes, sir.
Huh. So what's the plan? Also, that guy. Is he straight from Suikoden 2? Or is he just dressed like him? That'd be kind of cool to have some actual characters that are in Suikoden 2. Anyway, it looks like all the guards are getting knocked out by the food. But is that everyone going to be knocked out because they ate the food? Or is it just going to be the guards? Did anybody not eat? Oh, shit.
Aha! Caught you.
To hell? Is that like a fucking assassin sneaking in? Oh, shit. Get wrecked, homie. Y'all thought you were sneaky.
We knew you guys would put Dark Arcanum in the bank.
Owned!
And that's why we all took an antidote beforehand.
Owned!
We've got you all now. Don't even try to make any excuses. Godwin didn't see this coming, I bet.
Owned! Fools.
What did you say?
The reason we used that drug was so we wouldn't have to sacrifice so many of you. Now there's only going to be more unnecessary bloodshed.
Give up! You have no chance!
Is that so?
Yeah, it is so. Watch as you get motherfucking wrecked, homie. You fools. So, okay, the plan was they weren't going to kill everyone. But you know what? It doesn't matter, because your assassins aren't going to be... You know what this sucks, though? You know, he just said there's not going to be any unnecessary bloodshed. But that means that the people who aren't able to actually defeat these guys are going to have a hell of a time.
Here we go.
And it's probably going to go unwell for the... Yeah, I think their main goal is probably to kill the mom. I'm telling you, the mom has got to be the main goal here. Because they kill the mom, then the daughter is, you know, in line for succession. So it makes sense. Although you would think Godwin wouldn't want to rush the marriage part before, just so he would actually be married to her already, you know? But whatever. I'm not going to try to question what the hell this guy's plan is. I'm just going to do my thing. Shorty, do my thing. I'm not going to waste my women on this guy. I don't know how hard he actually is. I'm only healing because I can and need to. Get him. Get him. Booyah, bitch. You dead. One assassin can't take on three homies. Nice. Alright, cool. Good start. Who else wants some? I'm assuming we're going to have to go around and save everybody, or at least help save everybody.
What was that? He's tough as a demon. I wonder if he's a member of a...
Of?
Who are you? Answer me! Damn, poison! Looks like he took the easy way out. We might have underestimated our enemy. If there are any more this tough, we're in trouble.
Yeah, I know. I'm worried about mother and... Let's get out of here! No, let's go save Mom and Lim.
Yes, me too. Let's at least go get downstairs.
Yes, indeed.
Leon? Coming!
What? She knows something. You know something. Speak easy, BZ. You know something. Well, shit. Remember when I was waiting for shit to go down? I think we found the part where shit's going down. I can't stop now. I want to know what's going down here. Well, I mean, we know what's going down, but I want to see how this goes. I'm not going to stop in the middle of it yet. If there's another point to stop in the middle of it, I will, but we're not quite at an episode, at least not for this Let's Play. Anyway.
They're still battling. We haven't fought them off yet, or could they be beating us? We're not going to help anyone standing here. Let's go!
Indeed. Shut your mouth and let's go. Should we check every quarter, or are we good? I don't know. I don't think there's any reason to check all these rooms. Let's just go. Oh, of course there's random battles. Why wouldn't there be? Don't be more of those assassin guys. Okay, these are just the soldiers. Time to get owned, soldiers. Shooky! Get him. Get him, Funk. Nice. Boom, yo crossbow ass. Godwin soldier. Kill that one. Kill that one. Get rid of that one first. He did. Alright. Get him, Funk. Get him. Get him. Now kill him. Kill him now.
Kill him. Kill him now.
Alright, got some rugged leather for victory. Alright. Gotta keep him down on my HP, man. Gotta remember that shit doesn't reset every battle or anything like that. Should we go this way? Oh.
This way is blocked. We have to find another way.
Okay, so I guess we're going downstairs. That's fine. That's fine. Like, I'm really that surprised. Uh-oh.
What's that? Oshtat didn't use the sun rune.
Uh-oh. Bad things. Bad things. Bad things. Alright, who's down?
Look.
Somebody looks down. Oh, is it just soldiers? Okay, that's fine.
Too late. He only has one wound. A fatal one.
Damn.
We're not dealing with any amateurs here.
Damn.
I'd say that fellow was a little too weak, that's all.
Oh, shit. Kildrick. It's this douchebag.
Well, well. Hello there. I'm glad to see you saved us the trouble of coming to get you.
But why are you... I get it now. You never were a gladiator in the first place, were you?
Very perceptive of you. At the Sacred Game Finals, you had to go and interrupt me just when we were getting to the very best part. I've been hoping to get the chance to thank you for that, you know.
Back off!
Now I see. You're the reason our Dark Arcanum didn't work, aren't you?
Who are you?
Don't you remember me? I guess I really shouldn't be surprised. We were just little kids back then. But I remember you, Mismar.
Mikafut!
Mikafut?
No, that's impossible.
So you do remember me then?
This just keeps getting better and better. Imagine that, a Queen's Knight's apprentice, His Royal Highness's bodyguard, one of our old friends.
Leon, what are these guys talking about?
Prince!
She must have been like a baby in the Assassin League or whatever before she escaped or something. Oh, we're gonna have to fight these guys. Alright, fuck it! Dolphin's Childrich! Fucking get some, Dolph Ziggler and fucking childish man. Wow, I didn't think we'd be fighting these guys here, but here, alright, here we go. Well, maybe, I mean, I could have probably guessed the Dolph dude, but not Childrich. I didn't know he was even here. Okay, what do I want to do? I guess we're going to just go straight for Dolph Lundgren over here, and then I'm going to use the potion. Use medicine on Funk. Yes. Get him. Get that Dolph Ziggler bitch. Right. Double team, bitch. Owned. Get some. Ow. Dude, really? You killed me before I even got to heal. Are you serious? That's garbage. Garbage. Well, I guess we're just gonna use magic then. Because fuck my life. I can't even believe that just happened. That's some bullshit, dude. I should have healed before I got downstairs. I didn't know it was gonna be that ridiculous, though. Is this a winnable battle? This is not looking very winnable. I don't know if it matters if we win or lose this right now. We're going to find out. Because right now, I fucked up on not healing beforehand, so we're really fucked right now. Yeah, I'm just going to hope that this is like one of those things you don't have to win. Because my damage is so low. And they just kicked my candy ass. see if that was a thing, or if I'm going to get a game over right now. Nope, that definitely doesn't matter.
Such a shame. Your talents used to exceed even mine.
Knights. Your fighting style's all stanted form. It's about as practical as dancing in a real fight. You all deny the one thing that really matters in combat. The killing!
Such a waste of time.
Ooh, this one still has the strength to stand. And such fire in her eyes makes me want to tear them right out of her sockets. Maybe it'd be more entertaining to just gut her precious prince right in front of her.
Yeah, good luck with that, dude. I'm about to go fucking ape on your ass, homie. No? It won't let me? It's gonna just... Oh, shit. King's Knight for the win! Zegai. Hell yeah, baby.
Kyle! Zegai.
See, that's why we brought Zegai back with us, baby. He's here to help. That's right. Yeah, go Rune Power, baby. Go, Kyle.
It's your birthday.
Right, you don't fuck with the Queen's Knights, bitch. And they're gone. E dicks.
Damn.
Shookie. Now what?
You saved us.
Sorry, it took us so long.
Okay.
Never mind that. What's the situation?
It's not good, man. The enemy is unnaturally strong, much more powerful than our guards. Our defense has been shattered. I might not have even made it here myself if I hadn't got help from Zegai. Where could Lord Godwin have found soldiers like these, man?
They're Nethergate members. I'm positive of it.
Nethergate, okay.
What?
But Ashtat disbanded them. I know. Lord Godwin secretly took them over. No, that can't be true. Nethergate killed Jizzle's mother, Moskal's wife. They've been mortal enemies ever since. And you're saying that Godwin has had Nethergate on his side for 8 years? Yes, I am.
Leon, how could you be so sure, man?
I'm sorry. I promise I'll tell you all about it some other time.
Oh.
After we get out of here. Prince, we have to go now.
Okay. I can't leave Mother and Lim, though, for real.
Your first priority is getting away. Nethergate wants your blood, too.
Prince, you have to understand. You have to protect your bloodline. That means fleeing at a time like this, even if you want to stay and fight. You'll have to let us do our job and protect your family at any cost. I'll find your majesty and the princess. You and Lady Silides better run now.
All right, fine.
Is that all right with you, Lady Silides?
Yes, just take care of Ashtat and Lim.
I won't let you down.
Better not.
Leon, I'm leaving. The prince and Lady Silides safety in your hands.
You gonna take Zegai with you? I could use him. Can I have Zegai?
Alright, I'd better see you again, Kyle.
Zegai, will you go with the prince too?
Yeah!
I'd rather stay. There's more fighting here.
I know, but please, I'd feel much better if I knew you were with him.
Fine.
Thanks, bruh. I'll leave first. Give me a bit of head start, then make your escape.
Alright, thanks, Kyle.
Good luck!
Thanks, Kyle. So we got Zegai. Sick. He's probably beast. Since we don't have George, we got a new beast. His name is Zegai. Let's switch the party around a little bit then. Because you know he gonna be beast. Let's put him in the front, yo. I mean, he may be medium range, but he needs to be up in the front, yo. He needs to be up in the front, yo. Alright, that'll do. Yup. I'm actually tempted to just go... I really kind of want to go back to my normal formation. If I didn't get more stats from being in other formations, I probably would go back to normal formation.
Hold on a minute.
Okay.
Let's head toward the Queen's Knights Guards room. I know an escape route.
Okay. Let's do that. An escape route. Is it the other door that's in the room? Probably.
George
is here. Of course he is.
You guys... What are you all still doing here?
What about you? Aren't you supposed to be with Ashtat and Farad? George.
The Queen.
Oh, shit.
And Farron.
Already?
They're dead.
No, already? Well, I predicted that part right.
What? But Farron...
No. How can that be? George, you were with them. How?
I'm sorry.
Well, then. Do we even get to see what happened?
I'm sorry, but there's no time to grieve now. The Sun Palace is about to fall. You've got to get out.
Wait. Just a minute. If Arshtad is dead, then that means the Sun Rune must have gone back to the sealed room. That means if Godwin gets a hold of it...
Kyle went to the sealed room for us. All you have to do is concentrate on getting the hell out of here.
What about Lim, dude?
Don't worry, she's all right. Miyake's and Galleon are with her. Leave Lim to them.
I have to at least save Lim. Come on, man. I don't want to leave the Sun Rune either. I feel like we need to grab that shit. No, Prince, we have to leave right now.
I don't like putting it like this, but in a way, Lim is already safe.
Okay.
Look, the Godwins intend to install Lim as a figurehead queen and then somehow control her. The fact that they waited until after the official engagement before they made their move proves that. So there's no way they're going to harm Lim now. True that, but you and Silene will just get in their way. They'd love to kill you both.
That's right! Exactly. The princess already lost her mother and father today. You can't let her lose you too. You too, too. For her sake, you have to run.
All right, fine.
Aren't you worried about Lim?
I'm just gonna be stubborn as hell.
Of course I'm worried. How could you ask me that? But I'm your bodyguard, Prince. His Majesty Ferret ordered me to protect you at all times, no matter what. I can't let you go, and that's final.
Fine. Let's go.
Prince.
Okay, let's go.
Oh, so we are gonna get George.
You too, Zegai.
I was already planning to.
There's an escape route up ahead. Let's hurry.
Oh my god, dude. So Ferret and Arshtad are just dead. Dude, we don't even get to see why or how? Man, I mean, okay, I guess we know why, but we don't get to see how? I really wanted to see a scene where we see who did it and why, like, how it went down and everything. That's kind of lame. I really wanted to see that. Not that I really wanted to see them die. But come on, man. I feel like I got left hanging there a little bit. I mean, whatever. I'm not going to be mad about it. But, you know, sometimes when stuff happens that's not in the realm of your character because it's his point of view, you just don't get to see it. I understand that.
Is this the right way?
Yes. Hold on a second.
Your king, your queen's knight. You should know these things. See? Secret passages.
Secret passages.
Okay. How long are we going to stand here for?
This way, hurry.
That was like a long loading from between when she opened it and when it fucking loaded. Interesting. All right, what do we got down here? A whole lot of underground passageness. Hopefully no fights. Hopefully no fights. Run like hell. I feel like we're not going to get out of here without having one confrontation. Someone's going to be guarding this or on the way or something, right? Nope, there's just a boat.
A boat, eh?
This was all set up long ago for emergency escapes. We're probably the first to have to use it, though.
Okay. Well, let's hope there's no douchebags behind us. Let's get out of here.
Okay, we're shoving off. Get in.
Get in, quickly. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Don't do it.
Prince. Please. Please don't look back, Your Highness.
So of all the possible outcomes that I kind of discussed earlier, this was the one I actually expected most, like, that had the highest probability. And, well, that's exactly what happened. So, there you go. They didn't get too complicated on it. They went pretty obvious. But that's cool. Whatever. Let's see what happens with the Sun Rune, though. That's the part I'm curious to see what happens.
That light. The Sun Rune. It's returning to the sealed room. It's true, then. Arshtad.
I mean, Sun Rune isn't exactly something we want. That shit can corrupt your ass. Maybe we want. Maybe the point is we're gonna get ourselves another different rune.
I'm trying. Where are my mother and father?
You don't want to know.
Galleon, weren't you with them?
Princess.
What's the matter? Zahok, Alania, what are you two doing here?
Princess, stay back.
What's going on?
Hello, Princess. And where might you be going?
What?
Oh.
Oh, no.
Did they get betrayed by them?
What? Tell me what's going on here.
You're the ruler of Sun Palace now, Princess. We can't just let you leave now, can we?
Why are you...
Wow. Of course two of the Queen's Knights. I mean, they were very Godwin... you know, they seemed like they would be Godwin backers, and now they definitely have proved that. I should have known that would happen. Anyway, this can't be true. Her Majesty is... No! It's all because the Dawnrun went missing. I told you something like this would happen. How could a Queen's Knight do such a thing? The rotten traitor! The poor princess, what will she do now? Good question. We're all really fucked now, that's all I can say. Hey, is that George? What the hell? Didn't expect to see George running across the bottom there any times. Hey, I'm actually not wearing my stupid orange outfit. That's nice. Wait, am I? Yeah, I'm not wearing my stupid orange outfit. Exactly. I have returned for my reconnaissance, Your Highness.
Good work. So, what did it say?
We're all wearing different outfits completely. Wow, this is kind of cool. Well, it said that Solfaline is virtually under the control of Lord Godwin now. But, thankfully, the princess is apparently safe.
So, the princess wasn't able to escape, huh? But she's alive, that's what matters. We'll find a way to rescue her later, somehow.
Alright. There is one more thing. It pains me even to say this, but a certain despicable lie was also written. Queen's Knight George Prime murdered Her Majesty the Queen and His Majesty Farid, then took the prince hostage and fled. Ah, shit, dude.
Oh no, that's horrible! Trying to put the blame on George? How dirty can they be?
They intend to send a search party out this very morning.
Your Highness, this isn't a safe place to hide anymore. Might I suggest you go to Lunas and seek Lady Haswar's help, sir? Yes, that's a good idea.
I guess we're gonna go back to Haswar then. I'm sorry we don't have the strength to avenge Your Majesty and His Majesty. We can't even fight to protect our prince or Lady Xylides.
Please forgive our uselessness. Don't say that. Just hiding us until this morning has been a huge help.
Oh, what gracious words. Prince, Lady Xylides, an atrocity like this must be punished. Please, please survive, and someday please return justice to our fair Felina. We beg you. I will do just that, sir. So I'm wearing a more regular looking outfit, and George seems to be wearing the outfit I remember him wearing from Suikoden 2, baby. Outfits are different now. I like it. Anyway, I guess we're on our way to freaking... Can we go back in there? I won't let me. God damn it. Can we save it out here on the world map then? Options. Can I save it out here or no? Really? Alright, well I guess we gotta get to somewhere where I can save it. Let's just do that, I guess. Well, I mean, once we get to... Let's just get to freaking... whatever it's called. Let's just get over to Lunas as quickly as possible and try to save it. But now we're on the run and everybody's wearing different outfits. See, here we go. Now I look more interesting. I like my outfit more now. It's red. I look like I'm a fighter and not a weirdo with a poncho on. Look at that. It looks way cooler, right? I think so. And George is wearing his old school outfit that he wore in Suikoden 2 now. I like that. Definitely a throwback. Makes me get all nostalgic and shit. And then Xylides and Leon are wearing different outfits too. I'm down for people wearing different outfits. I actually like this a lot. I was kind of wondering if that was going to be the case. Like early on, we get to see everybody in their, you know, their official fucking outfits, but later we get to see them in more unique to the story outfits. Like look at Leon in her fucking clothes, those baggy ass samurai pants. Just looks funny. That's all. I think she was already wearing some samurai-looking pants. I mean, the outfits that the Queen's Knights were wearing were very samurai-ish earlier. Anyway, I'm actually quite surprised. Well, I shouldn't say surprised, but I'm happy that a couple of the Queen's Knights were traitors and they weren't just all loyal just to be loyal. I'm glad a couple were traitors. I like that there was some assassin guys that were involved there with Childrich and
we did it!
And whatever his name was, I already forgot his name. The douche one, the one that said he knew Leon. I'm blanking on his name already. Those two guys, Dolph, that was his name. Your Highness, Lady Silides, are you all right? Yeah, I'm good. The Oracle is quite distressed over your well-being. Please come to see her right away.
You mean the news has already traveled all the way out here?
Only the vaguest details. This morning, a mounted messenger back from Sol Felina told us of an attack, but it was hardly more than rumors. But
let's save the chat for later. Right now, the Prince and Lady Silides need to get some rest.
Yes, of course, my apologies. This way, please. Just join my party so I can save and quit. Please? 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 Ah, sweet. Okay.
Next time on Let's Play Suikoden 5, we will see what the fallout is of this bullshit. Shit went down today, guys. I knew it was coming, and I was kind of hoping it was going to be today, and now here we are. So, the most probable of outcomes is what happened. The princess will now be used as a figurehead leader, while Godwin really controls the country. But right now, it seems like pretty much most of the country is still behind my side, on Arstadt's side. There's not a lot of people who seem to be on the opposite side, at least not from this area of the country. We haven't been to the rest of the world yet. Who knows what the rest of the world thinks of this whole bullshit? We'll have to just travel the world and find out, and I'm thinking we're going to have to start our adventure of recruiting people and all that good stuff. But where will our castle, or I should say our base, end up being? That's something I'm really interested to see, because every Suikoden game, you got a base of operations. I'm wondering what that will be for us. It might be a while before we get to that point, so we'll see. I'm going to stop babbling on, and I'll see you guys next time on the next one. Peace out.